Hey there, this is Mehdi from stronglips.com, and in this video I'm gonna reveal the secret to gaining muscle naturally without using drugs or supplements and training only 3 times a week. The muscle gaining technique that I'm about to share with you has been used by some of the best built guys that ever existed and is extremely efficient for guys with lousy genetics who always struggle to gain muscle and who tried everything already with little or no results. In fact, I've personally used this muscle gaining technique to gain 43 pounds of almost all muscle while burning my belly fat and man boobs and without ever using drugs. So let's get straight into the point. Here's the secret to gaining muscle. It is to get stronger. This means that the more weight you add on the bar when you're in the gym, the stronger you'll become and the more muscle your body will build. It's that simple, really. In fact, most guys won't be able to gain significant amounts of muscle naturally unless they become stronger first. This is especially true if you have bad genetics like I do and are more of the skinny ectohard gainer type with small bones. And as I'll show you in a minute, almost all of the most accomplished bodybuilders that ever existed, both past and present, are freaking strong as well. And that is no coincidence. It's because more strength is more muscle. Now, what this really means is that in order to gain muscle, you don't need to do high rep isolation exercises like biceps curls, dumbbell flies, leg extension, triceps kickbacks and all that crap. You don't need to go to the gym 5 times a week to train one body part per day either. You also don't need to do 27 different exercises per workout to hit each muscle from every possible angle. And you definitely don't need to do high reps until failure, because getting pumped or waking up sore the next day doesn't guarantee that you'll actually gain muscle. The only thing that does is getting stronger. Again, more strength is more muscle. So stop wasting your time on all that high rep isolation bullshit. What you also don't need to gain muscle are all those freaking supplements. First, the large majority of them don't work anyway. They'll claim steroid-like muscle gains, which is bullshit, because if that was actually true, then they'd be illegal just like the steroids are. A few supplements like whey protein can be convenient, but in no case are they mandatory for gaining muscle. Quite the opposite, in most cases they're a complete waste of money, because no supplement will ever make up for training like a moron. That's why every gym has at least one guy who drinks 5 shakes a day and yet has little or no muscles to show for. If you aren't getting stronger, you won't gain muscle, period. So stop wasting your money on all those bogus supplements. The bottom line is that in order to gain muscle, you don't need to do all that bullshit written in those dumb muscle magazines. You don't need their high rep isolation split routines, and you don't need their bogus supplements either. The only thing that you really need in order to gain muscle is to get stronger, because again, more strength is more muscle. So stop being a muscle magazine victim. If you're now a skeptic and think that I'm bullshitting you, here is some proof that backs up what I'm saying. Here are some bodybuilding champions who achieved world-class physiques and who also happen to be freaking strong. First, there's Arnold Schwarzenegger, who won the Mr. Olympia title 7 times and who is considered the most accomplished bodybuilder that ever existed. Few guys know that he was a competitive powerlifter before he became a professional bodybuilder. Some of Arnold's best lifts include a 710 pounds deadlift, 440 pound bench press and a 472 pound squat. Arnold was strong. And it's by getting strong, not by doing those bullshit high rep isolation split routines, that he built his muscular physique. Next, there's Arnold's training partner, Franco Colombo. Franco won the Mr. Olympia title 4 times and was even stronger than Arnold. He could deadlift 750 pounds, squat 665 pounds, and he could bench press 525 pounds. Like Arnold, Franco did powerlifting for several years and he even competed for the World Strongest Man title. It's by getting stronger that Franco built his muscular physique as well. Now maybe you're thinking, yeah, but these guys, they all took steroids, so this whole more strength is more muscle thing, it doesn't really apply to natural lifters like you and me. Okay, fine. Here are some examples from drug-free bodybuilding champions. First, Arnold Schwarzenegger. Well, I mean, he learned how to gain muscle from his mentor, Rec Park. Rec Park was the first guy in Europe to bench press 500 pounds, he could squat 600 pounds and he could deadlift 700 pounds. Rec Park won the Mr. Universe title 3 times and, this is really important, he achieved this during the 1950s, before steroids even existed. So Park has proved that more strength is more muscle, even for natural drug-free lifters like you and me are. Consider also Dr. Lane Norton, PhD, who is a professional champion bodybuilder and a lifetime natural drug-free lifter. Lane also happens to be an elite powerlifter with a 700-pound deadlift, 500-pound bench press and a 600-pound squat. Now why the heck does Lane train for strength if he's a bodybuilder? Well, because he knows that more strength is more muscle. I could give you example after example that more strength is more muscle all day long. There's Ronnie Coleman, 8-time Mr. Olympia, who could deadlift 800 pounds. There's Sergio Oliveira, 3-time Mr. Olympia, who could lift over 300 pounds overhead. There's IFBB Pro bodybuilder Stan Efferding, who deadlifts 800 pounds. The list goes on and on and on and on. And the point is this, the best built guys didn't build their physique by doing high rep dumbbell curls while standing on one leg on a Bosu ball. They did it by getting stronger, and that's because more strength is more muscle. So the big question is, how strong are you? How much do you bench? How much do you squat? How much do you deadlift? Unless you're a genetic freak, or unless you are using steroids, I mean, if you aren't capable to lift decent amounts of weights, then I'm willing to bet that you don't have much muscles to show for either. And that's no coincidence. You need to get stronger to gain muscles, especially if you're a natural, drug-free lifter with lousy genetics like I am. Now, the good news is that you don't need to deadlift 700 pounds like Arnold did. However, if you want a bigger chest, you need to increase your bench press to 200 pounds at least. And I'm talking about 220 pounds using free weights, not machines, not a Smith, and with a bar touching your chest on every single rep. So to get a bigger chest, you need to increase your bench press to 220 pounds at least. In the same way, if you want bigger legs, you need to increase your squat to 300 pounds at least. Here too, I'm talking about 300 pounds using free weights, not machines, and with your hips going below parallel on each rep. And if you want a bigger back with ski slope traps, then you need to increase your deadlift to 400 pounds at least. All of this will do more for your body than all the high rep, isolation, crap, or any kind of supplements you'd ever find. Why? Because more strength is more muscle. If you aren't getting stronger in the gym, you're wasting your time. You need to start adding weight to the bar, and you need to start doing this today. To be honest, if you would have told me like 13 years ago that you need to get stronger in order to build muscle, I would have thought you were nuts. I actually used to believe that you need to train 5 times a week, one muscle group per day with at least 10 different isolation and machine exercises, one incline, one decline, one for each side of the muscle, one for the outside, everything for high reps until pumped, each set taken until failure. I mean, if I woke up sore, I thought I had a good workout. That's a kind of body part split routines that I did for 4 full years. I'm sure it sounds familiar to you. Quite frankly, I did gain some muscle with that at first, but I eventually plateaued, lost motivation, and I got tired of training until failure 5 times a week. Unfortunately, I didn't know any other way to train, so I just kept doing what I had always done and was familiar with. Then during the summer of 2003, I went on holiday to Turkey with 2 friends from the gym, and there some guys challenged us at arm wrestling. And we took the challenge because we were confident about winning. After all, we trained and they didn't. So, long story short, to our surprise, the 3 of us ended up losing. I really felt embarrassed about that because after 4 years of training like a maniac and becoming one of the strongest guys in the gym on the machines, it turned out that I couldn't do anything with that strength at all outside the gym. So I was thinking, what the heck is all that training for then? That's when I actually realized that I had wasted my time building fake gym strength. It was all show, puffy, water-filled muscles from the pump training, but nothing else. Once I was back in Belgium, I started doing some research, and that's when I discovered that you need compound free weight exercises to build real-world strength, not that isolation and machine crap. So I searched for a free weight routine, and that's when I stumbled upon the 5x5 workout from Rick Park, the same workout that his pupil Arnold Schwarzenegger used to build his physique. Now, I like that RecPark 5x5 routine only took 3 workouts a week because that would save me a lot of time. However, it had no isolation exercises, no arm work, no calf works, no high reps, only 3 exercises for 5 sets of 5 reps 3 times a week. Frankly, I was skeptic and I was also afraid that it wouldn't work and that I'd lose all the muscles that I had built. So I dismissed RecPark 5x5 routine and just went back to the good old body part split routines. Few months later, what then happened is that I got kicked out of the gym, trained in another gym for a couple of months, but it was too far away, so I eventually decided to build a home gym in the garage of my parents. Bought a power rack, a bar, weights and a bench, all good. Except I just needed a free weight routine now, since I no longer had access to machines, and that's when I remembered the 5x5 routine from Rec Park. I was still skeptic, But I didn't know what else to do. Plus, I figured that if I ended up losing muscle, I could always drive to the gym like maybe once a week for extra machine work. So I decided to give the 5x5 routine a try. And to my surprise, the 5x5 routine, it made me stronger, but it not only made me stronger. What also happened is by training for strength instead of pump, my physique improved as well. Basically, it got denser and more balanced. I also started to have a life outside of the gym now because I only trained 3 times a week for about an hour instead of the previous 5 times a week for 2, sometimes 3 hours. So this 5x5 workout, it changed my life. It simply changed my life, and I never went back to the body part split routines after this. It's kind of interesting looking back because this 5x5 routine, it should not have worked for me when you think about it. Because I'm not one of those guys who's genetically gifted. I'm an ectomorph with a skinny build, the hard gainer type. In fact, my thumb overlaps my middle finger when I grab my wrist. So I was not born to be big and strong. Worse, I never even did any kind of sports before I got into lifting. I used to spend my days playing video games or watching TV, and not only was I a couch potato, I was also eating junk all the time. So on top of being skinny, I also had man boobs and belly fat. I was the skinny fat type who quite frankly always felt uncomfortable going shirtless. On top of that, I was also extremely weak before I started lifting weights, so I'm not one of those guys who could bench 220 pounds his first day in the gym. Many moons ago, I lost at arm wrestling to all my friends and then a girl. Worse, when they started doing push-ups, I couldn't do one rep without while that same girl could. And as a guy, being weaker than a girl, I mean, that was a huge humiliation and a blow to my ego. And that's actually what motivated me to start working out. Which didn't turn out to be quite a day at the beach. The first time I did squats, I ended up puking. That's how weak and out of shape I was. And talking about the squat, I actually have scoliosis and my left leg is shorter than my right leg, which has caused many lower back issues over the years. So that's all the reason why this program should not have worked for me, and yet it did work because today I squat 490 pounds, 419 pounds, which is more than 2.5 times my body weight. I also deadlift 500 pounds, which is triple my body weight. And by getting this strong, I managed to gain 43 pounds of almost all muscle while losing my belly fat and man boobs once and for all. And again, I did this without ever using any kind of drugs or steroids. I'm a lifetime natural lifter, and I did it by getting stronger using the 5x5 workout first. I'm not doing the Strongly 5x5 workout anymore today because I got too strong for the program. The point is that you get stronger than continue with other programs. But I still use the 5x5 philosophy today of adding weight over time, compound free weight exercises. I mean, that's still how I train today. Years later. And what happens over the years is that a lot of my friends, they started to, I mean, they noticed how I had gained muscle, and when you gain muscle and your friends see it, well, it's common that a couple of them, they start to become interested in the same thing. So I started to get them, like questions from them, like, how did you do it, and all that kind of stuff. I told them that the secret to gaining muscle was to get stronger. I gave them the 5x5 workout from Rec Park that I had great results with. And of course, they too start to gain muscle with this routine, just like I had done. Eventually, in 2007, one of my friends, he's just straight told me that I should start a website that showed guys how to gain muscle by getting stronger. And I didn't really think it was a good idea at first, but eventually I decided to go with it. Started StrongLifts.com, quit my job in the IT world. Put the 5x5 routine of Rec Parks online for free. People from all over the world, they started to gain muscle with it as well, and they actually started to call it Strongly 5x5, even though it's not my invention. It's a Rec Parks routine from back in the 1950s. He's the one who came up with this. And 5 years later, almost 6 years later now, there's I mean, thousands and thousands of thousands of guys. I get like emails every day of guys who tell me that they gain more muscle in only 12 weeks of 5x5 than in the past 12 years doing body part split routines. It's I mean, that's not a coincidence. There's a simple reason why Strongly 5x5 works so well for gaining muscle, and that's because it gets you stronger. It gets you stronger quickly. It gets you stronger safely. It gets you stronger without using drugs, without getting you injured, and training only 3 times a week. And again, when you get stronger, you're gonna gain muscle. Even if you have lousy genetics, I would say, especially if you have lousy genetics, if you get stronger, you're gonna gain muscle, because more strength is more muscle. It's that simple. The Strongly505 program is available for free on strongly505.com. You can visit my website to download a free copy of the ebook that explains the full workout. There's no catch, it's really free, it's 100% free. I'm just trying to get as many people on the program as possible because, well, I want their success stories, that's the truth. More videos are coming later. You can subscribe to this YouTube channel, of the Strongest YouTube channel. You can subscribe to it if you haven't already to get free video updates. And of course, do me a favor, like this video, add it to your favorites, this way more guys find it. That's it for now, and I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.